You know, when people began to realize back in the 80s that there was this link between the brain and the immune system that was more profound than we originally thought, right? I mean, originally people thought the immune system was down there dealing with infection, their brain was about behavior. Now, of course, we know that they're really one system. People thought about it in terms of immune suppression. You know, I mean, I think so many things are lost from the lives of people with depression that it sort of made thematic sense to think that your immune functioning might be lost too. So it was really quite a shock in the 90s when assays got better and we began to realize that if you measured inflammatory markers, so these are chemicals like cytokines that get kicked up when you get the flu, something like that, then when you looked at those sort of chemicals, they were actually elevated in depressed people. And this was shown sort of again and again. And then we began to realize that if you were exposed to these chemicals, you were likely to get depressed. So some of the research that we did, and many other people did, beginning about 2000, was with drugs like interferon. So there's this thing called interferon-alpha, which was used somewhat in cancer, but a great deal for many years to treat hepatitis C. And it's a chemical your body makes that basically turns on inflammation. You know, if I were to take you and inject a bunch of interferon-alpha into your arm, within an hour you'd be feeling sick. You'd have a fever, you'd feel, you know, crappy, and you'd want to lay down. And it activates all these inflammatory chemicals in your body. Turns out that if people do that to themselves on a repeated basis for something like curing hepatitis C, a very significant proportion of them become depressed. Many become like really clinically depressed, suicidal, hopeless, helpless.
Long term
while you're getting the treatment. The interesting thing is that the vast bulk of people recover pretty much completely within a couple of weeks of stopping it. So it really is this sort of drag. You know, if you're constantly exposed to inflammatory stimuli at a high level, you know, people get exhausted, depressed, or sleep gets messed up. Unfortunately, there are actually a number of data points suggesting that some people do have long term, you know, sort of mood disturbances after a chronic bout of inflammation from interferon. We know it from other studies, sort of population studies, that if you have episodes of inflammation earlier in life, so for instance, if you have an autoimmune condition or if you have bad infections, the kind of infections that land you in the hospital, you're significantly more likely to subsequently develop significant major depression, but significant schizophrenia and other disorders too, right? So it looks like there's something about chronic inflammatory activation that induces changes in the brain and body that tee you up for depression. And in fact, we can talk about this. We know a lot about what those changes are. So there was this convergence of data suggesting that inflammation, the sorts of acute, especially acute reactions your body does to dangerous pathogens, that those chemicals induce inflammation, induce depression. Now, we and others were some of the first to suggest that there may be an evolutionary advantage to inflammation inducing depression. And we could talk about that. But the fact that those things are linked is pretty clear.